All right, this is another video response to Together for Peace. I'm not gonna make any fucking sense unless you've seen this video. So don't fucking tell me that I'm an asshole and I sound like a goddamn retard because I'm not making any sense unless you watch this video. If you watch this video and I'm still not making any goddamn sense, then I'm doing something wrong, but whatever. So you asked a question, or you implied a question at least, Together for Peace. You said, basically, how does the Bible imply that the earth is 6,000 years old? Well, I'm with you. I don't think the Bible does say that. But I don't think that the Bible really says any of the things that most of people think it says. I think the Bible is a nice little story, like Little Bo Peep, Humpty Dumpty, Jack and the Beanstalk. But basically, the way that they can justify it is they say that the Bible is the literal word of God and is therefore infallible. So if the Bible is the word of God, well then, sure, what the fuck? We can believe whatever the hell's in it. And that means that we can take Jesus's, like, birthday, which was 2009 or so years ago. Excuse me. And then we can add up the genealogy, you know? Jesus was begat by Joseph, who was begat by, well, it depends on whether you're reading Luke or Matthew. Matthew says Joseph, Jesus' father, was begat by Jacob, and Luke says that Jesus' father was begat by Heli. But you get the point. You go back all the way to the beginning of the timeline with the begat, 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 and then you add up all the estimated ages. And again, we don't have exact ages, of course, and we don't have exact time frames for it, but we do know about how long people supposedly lived in the Bible, because the Bible gives a couple of little stories that give us hints. So, with that number, we can assume that all the way back to Adam and Eve, we can add up those numbers, and we can be even generous with it, and it's somewhere between 6 and 10,000 years. So that's how stupid people justify the Earth's age as being represented in the Bible. If you believe in the Bible, if you believe the words of the Bible, then you have to believe that the Earth is between 6 and 10,000 years old. And I'll come back to that topic in just a second, but first I want to say about the topic of evolution that you were talking about. The Bible specifically says that God created man in his image. If he simply created man in the image of himself, which is our current form, then how can you justify believing that we evolved from a common ancestor as every other primate, who all evolved from a common ancestor as every other animal, who evolved from a common ancestor as every other living creature? The evolution and theology just they don't have matching parts. You can't put them together, no matter how much duct tape you use, and go, "Look how pretty it is," because it just doesn't work. It doesn't fucking work. It's a jigsaw and a hammer. You cannot use a hammer to put together a jigsaw. If the Bible is the literal word of God, you can't just pick and choose the parts that you want to ignore or believe. And if it isn't the literal word of God, if the Bible is not what we're really supposed to believe, if when it says homosexuality is an abomination, if what it actually meant was homosexuality is super fun and everyone should do it, you know, fucking, then why believe all the parts about this guy who was his own dad and also a zombie that there's no historical record of? Not one. With 32 plus historians living in the area where Jesus supposedly walked around and even was resurrected, and if you read that part of the Bible, it specifically says that the dead of the city got up out of their graves and walked around town. Well, if I were a historian, you can bet your butt I would write that down. Yes, sirree, Bob. But nobody did. Not a single thing that this Son of God did was ever written down by any historian. Okay? So, with the lack of that, and also with, by your very own admission, the Bible being whatever the word is that means it's not very trustworthy that I can't think of because I'm hungover. With the Bible being that fallible, then how do you justify believing any of this nonsensical, mystical, contradictory, gibberish bullshit? And furthermore, how do you justify trying to indoctrinate other people? Trying to tell them, well, you should believe this because this is what I believe. And if anyone tells you you're wrong, well, then they're wrong. And if they tell you that you're wrong about that, well, then you just stop talking to that person. The whole thing is not just intellectual, but it's a spiritual superiority complex. It's like you think you've found some all-encompassing answer that nobody else has. All of us silly atheists, we're just so wrong and so dumb. I can't even believe that we believe what we believe. Can you believe it? But you're better because you figured this stuff out all on your own. Yes, sure, you betcha. And anyone who disagrees is clearly a moron. You know, but when you put it together, it just doesn't add up. But that means that you're not special anymore. So you say, no, that's not true. I am special, God damn it! I found out something that you didn't know. You know what? You didn't find out anything I didn't know. I've read the Bible many a time, and let me assure you, it's bullshit. Pure, uncut, grade A bullshit. That's only George Carlin. Well, I think that's it for this video. Stop thinking with the mentality that you want to justify this belief. Start thinking just as if you want to understand. Just ignore all of your beliefs. Just put them away. Fresh mind. Read the Bible with a fresh and clear mind. Read it consciously, as if you were reading Dante's Inferno or Richard Dawkins' the God Delusion. Just think about every little piece of it and keep it in your head and remember it as you're reading the rest so that you can look back and say, wait a minute, this thing that I'm reading now contradicts the thing 2 chapters ago. That doesn't make any sense. Just think is the bottom line. Just fucking start thinking. Okay, I'm done. Later, dudes.